It's a service focused on keeping you and your family safe, and it doesn't cost a penny.
Local deputies will come out to your home and tell you if you've done enough to keep criminals from making you a target.
West 2's Meredith McDonough met up with one couple as they had every inch of their home checked out.
So from a perspective of somebody who might be looking at a house, so, well, I see a lot of lighting, I see cameras, I see signage that says the house is under surveillance. This is not the house for me.
Criminals beware. This house belongs to a retired couple in Seminole County. Kathy and George are getting advice on how to make their home safer and not a target for criminals. It's a free home security assessment from the sheriff's office.
I want it to be safe.
And so Kathy and George lived in South Florida for 35 years, but after their grandchildren arrived, they made the move to Central Florida. When looking at local numbers, in 2022, the Orange County Sheriff's Office responded to more than 1,500 residential burglaries and 21 home invasion robberies. Seminole County responded to more than 160 residential burglaries. For Kathy and George, their number one priority is the safety of their home and loved ones.
You can't be safe enough, especially during these trying times. And challenging times. You just have to be aware and cautious.
Reserve Deputy Sheriff Satish Mahajan and Citizen on Patrol Rose Harkey from the Seminole County Sheriff's Office went through every aspect of the home, from the outside to the inside.
Most important is the view from the outside, so the vegetation, the lighting, the camera system. Then we look at the internals, where we look at the locks, if there's an alarm system, and if there are motion sensors or glass break sensors.
Well, Kathy and George have a lot to be proud of.
Your windows are visible from the outside, okay? So you're already in a great place. I see that, you know, your bushes are trimmed very nicely. Everything looks great. You have a video doorbell already installed.
They also have a lot to learn. First up, lighting. Making sure the homeowner has motion sensors or dawn to dusk lights on timers. Second, the more cameras you have, the safer.
The key part about the cameras also is, as talked about, not necessarily the widest coverage, but having it so that you can see what goes on. And so that means the entire perimeter of the house should be on camera view.
Kathy loves her backyard vegetation, and it's a big reason why they bought this property, but it also poses a threat.
The yard, I notice you have a beautiful conservation area.
Right.
And one of the opportunities is, again, that's a potential entryway into your property. So you might want to consider fencing. At nightfall, when it's dark, this becomes an entry point.
Kathy was not thrilled about the idea of a fence, but certainly understands the safety aspect.
It made me sad because one of the reasons I love this piece of property was to back up on that, and I did not want a fence as an obstruction.
From fencing to landscape, these beautiful plants may provide privacy, but can also hide intruders.
General perspective is not to have hiding places or ambush points, as we call them. So trimming the vegetation so that, again, you can maintain privacy, but trimming them away from the house so that they'd be visible from this side.
As you head inside, make sure your front door lock anchors all the way in, so it's difficult to break the door down. A camera facing the front door is a visual deterrent and adds another layer of protection if someone does break in. Lastly, keep sets of keys out of sight. It's better than out in the open.
Someone in the house, could be a vendor, a contractor, could be anybody coming to the house and decides to take a key on their way out. Would you notice the keys missing?
Probably not.
Rose has been doing this for more than a decade and wishes more residents would have a proactive approach to home security.
I do follow-ups when people have been burglarized to offer the services, but it makes me feel sad that I haven't done it beforehand to tell them some of these items that they could have done to help prevent somebody from breaking into their home.
Once the walkthrough is complete, Kathy and George are left with a list of suggestions, something they say is well worth it.
I learned a lot. We're going to make some changes. And so many of the suggestions they had were $5, $10, $15. I'm going to go right to, when I'm done here, to Facebook and recommend to my local friends that they check on this, because it's a great service and it's free.
Meredith McDonough, West 2 News.